Excited about the win. Excited a bunch of young guys got to play. Disappointed in how I managed the game. I should have slowed it down earlier in the game. I should have taken all passes out. And should have been more respectful to our opponent. And I apologize to Arkansas Pine Bluff and Coach Thomas. I am excited about the young guys that were in there and made plays when given the opportunity, so you have to balance that. And I think I could have been a better head football coach tonight. So, questions?
Did you say something to their coach after the game?
I apologized, yeah. And he was respectful. He said they'll get better. And they will. He's got a great plan, and I visited with him before the game. You build a program. You don't snap your fingers. Football's different than any other sport. You got to take 5 years worth of guys and get them believing and working hard, retain them, get them believing. This will be a big test for them, I think, if they come back and they can get their heads up, because that was tough, I'm sure.
Can I assume the last touchdown, the idea was get one more first down and then take a knee?
It was a RPO, but he was told not to throw the ball. So, the play call is on the play chart as a RPO. You can't not, when you signal the number and it's 1, 2, 3 and you call it, and he should have handed the ball off, even though it was third and long. On the other hand, Mike Wanmaker was on scout team all week, and he saw how our sideline erupted in joy with him. So, ideally that happens earlier in the game, and it's not that big a discrepancy.
Will that ending leave a bitter taste at all from this game? Because, it was a lot of positives in this win.
Not a negative. I just think I want us all to learn that, there's being a good sportsman, being a good sport, being honoring to your opponent, and then there's the competition, and you balance that. And honestly, I'd never been in a situation like this, so I learned a little bit more. We should have went turtle earlier, slowed the game down, like I said, not throwing the ball. We threw two screens, which are behind the line of scrimmage, and we went for touchdowns. I just know this. I don't feel as good about the win as I should because of what happened.
How did you think your twos and threes did?
I thought they did. I think they were way ahead of last week in terms of their execution. Our ones had more penalties. Now, we started out with three straight penalties, I think, after talking about that, but I think we settled in. Some of that you just have to say it's youth. But I thought running the ball against their guys, I thought we did a really good job. That's what we were trying to do.
Their offense was pretty good. They made some plays. And that is two games in a row where giving up a few big plays, is that maybe a concern that you're still just giving up a few too many big plays defensively?
Any big play is a concern. The long run, that's an athlete. He went to our left and then went all the way back right, and we didn't. The old term was box him in, and he's the long touch or the long passes. We've got to be in control of the receiver and then be able to look and make the play. And you learn from everything. So those are things we need to work on this next week.
Did everyone who was available to play tonight play?
I believe so. Yeah, I believe so. In fact, I think we played some true freshmen that never would have played. And they were just in there for warm-ups, really, to help the fat guys not have as many hits pregame. So a special event in their life. So
that's a valuable thing, isn't it, to get those? A lot of times, like you just said, you're not expecting necessarily for that many game reps for some guys.
Anytime you're on the field, warming up is a positive. Get some butterflies going and looking around, that's experience. So if you get into a game, I think there's a lot of neat stories. Jake Wolf kicking a PAT and him coming up and thanking me for that opportunity. That's pretty cool. So there's a lot of neat things that happen in the game too.
You had a lot of big plays offensively, a lot of different ways to get those plays too. What's your read on that after two games where the offense has shown some diversity and some big playability?
Well, I think we felt we had that. I think most people, again, talked about who we had lost and that's kind of become a topic of refer back to what we, but we felt really good about our skill. You know, obviously when Taren's the quarterback, there's a chance to do a lot of special things. I am really impressed the way he's throwing the deep ball. You know, whether he's able to step into it and throw it on his back foot, he's doing a phenomenal job. And then our receivers are making plays. So I think Isaac Wallace had some big plays. Unfortunately, a couple big plays were called back, but, you know, we'll learn from that.
Is the is there more importance on the bye week this week because of the fact you've only played two games?
I don't know. We call it an improvement week, number one. I think it comes at a great time because we've got a lot of stuff to correct, whether it's the deep ball or penalties, our focus. To be 2-0 and feel like you got a lot of stuff to work on, I think, is a good situation because now we've got the improvement week. We'll do very little North Dakota State stuff. I think when you do that, you get way ahead in the game plan. And you put way too much stuff in, and you know, who knows what they're going to do. So we got to tone it down and get better.
You've had a chance to have Cannon Nelson play the last few weeks. What have you seen out of him?
I thought he made some really good improvements. Last week he didn't get to throw the football. This week it was early enough that he was able to throw, and he made a great throw to Wilde on the sidelines. Alex made a great catch. I think he's growing. Again, every rep adds to your confidence and so on. So happy with where he's at. I think some of those quarterbacks are pulling the ball on power when they shouldn't be, trying to get some yards of their own, but they get limited reps. So
it seems a little weird to say the preseason is over, non-conference, whatever, is over when you only had two games, but that's essentially where you're at. How do you feel about where this team is at going into conference play?
I feel good. I've made the statement, you know, when you're a national champion, you watch the film, you got a lot of stuff to work on. So whatever part of the season you're at, you got a lot of stuff to work on. The challenge is as a coaching staff to be objective enough to identify it and then focus on that and not do a drill that doesn't correct those things. And so I think we're in a good situation, yet we got a lot of stuff to work on.
Both your offense and your defense played really well tonight. How are you going to keep that momentum for those units going heading into the next game?
Well, we're going to grade them really tough. You know, we graded championship level. We want to grade at a 90% level in terms of lack of effort and lack of focus. That's really hard to do in a college football game. And so I think our grading will identify, it'll make them hungry. It'll make them think. If they want to be champions, it'll make them look at it and say, I got to correct those things. Thank you.